Firstly, place the tabs of the photoelectrode contact into the slots of the PTFE chamber. Secure the contact by tightening the hex bit grub screw from one side and tightening the photoelectrode contact banana plug from the other. Place your photoelectrode substrate such that the electrically conductive surface is touching the contact. Next, secure the substrate using the sample holder and associated thumb screws. Tighten the screws in a star pattern until the substrate is secure and the O-ring has formed a seal. Make sure not to over-tighten the screws at this stage, as this can result in them stripping the brass insets. Insert the additional screw and rotate the chamber around. Finally, place the O-ring into the inset of the inner part of the chamber. You've prepared one half of the photoelectrochemical flow cell. Prepare the other half using the exact same procedure. Place a membrane onto one of the halves of the flow cell, and then place the other half on top of that, such that the membrane is between the two O-rings. Align the screws with the insets, then tighten each of them slowly, going between each of them to not over-tighten one side. Ensure the gap between the two halves is uniform over the entire cell. Place plugs into ports on both cell halves and then counter or reference electrodes into the top ports. To ensure a gas-tight fit for the reference electrode, make sure the O-ring fits into the inset in the port. Before placing the reference electrode into the cell, make sure to remove the cap and tap to remove any trapped bubbles by the frit. Then, push the reference electrode in by applying pressure and twisting. Make sure the frit of the electrode is approximately halfway into the cell chamber. Finally, screw the tripod into the cell. Great job! You've finished the setup for our PTFE photoelectrochemical flow cell. If you have any queries, make sure to visit our website.